Be real, we're here in Midtown Manhattan. You're playing a show in Brooklyn tonight. Welcome to New York City.
Thank you very much.
Do you have a favorite part of New York City when you're here?
I mean, you know, we've been coming here since the early 90s and stuff, so, I mean, we know our way around pretty well. You know, when we have time to go hang out with various friends and stuff like that, go out to clubs and hang out, you know.
What's your favorite club?
Lately, it's been Club Sutra. My boy Tony Touch does a night there on Tuesday nights, and it gets pretty popping. You know, we were just there, and DJ Premier was there, and I mean, so many people: Nina Sky, DJ Kool Herc, who was pretty much the godfather of hip hop out here as far as DJs go. I mean, it was so many people, and the nightlife here is like no other. I'm in the fast lane and I won't stop. You ain't nothing but talk. You couldn't hang on the profile box. This life that I live, it ain't for the weak. I'm a bounty ass gangster that came off the street.
Alright, so tonight's show is at SOB's in Brooklyn, which isn't that far from the Cypress Hills neighborhood of Brooklyn.
Right.
Is there any relation between the band name and that neighborhood?
No, not really. A lot of people thought we were from there, but, the only connection that we really would have to it is there was a rapper named Ramel Z who did a record back on this album called Wild Style. It was for the movie Wild Style, based out of New York, and he mentioned a place called Cypress Hills, and Sendog and myself lived on a block called Cypress Ave in Southgate, and we were big fans of Ramel Z, so when he shouted out a place called Cypress Hill, we immediately snatched that and used that as our name, so a lot of people thought we came from that section of Brooklyn, you know, so we got a lot of love because of that, but it was influenced by that rapper who was speaking about that place in Brooklyn, so, you know, we get a lot of love here by default, and, you know, it's all good, man, I can't complain about that.
Now, the new album, Rise Up, comes out 420, which
right.
is appropriate, of course. Talk to me a little bit about the new songs.
Well, you know, we tried to do something a little different, you know, a little, with the sound, have some, try to make it more up-tempo feel, more aggressive, a little bit bigger of a sound, you know. And we did that by going after different producers who understood what the Cypress Hill vibe was and could add to whatever that vibe is now, you know. And we went after Tom Morello, Darren Malakian of System of a Down, Mike Shinoda, DJ, Pete Rock, Jake One. I mean, we went after a few people. And myself and Muggs did the other half of the album, and it turned out exactly the way we wanted it, man. We wanted a mostly hip-hop album, but with some heaviness to it. And, you know, it be more of an up-tempo, in-your-face type of record.
Well, you mentioned Tom Morello and Darian from System of a Down. These are some real metal or rap metal bands. Were you a fan of Rage and some of the other rap metal?
Most definitely, most definitely. We've been fans of those guys forever and fans of rock music since we were kids. I mean, you know, before I knew what hip-hop was, I was a metalhead. I mean, I listened to everything because I was, you know, in the household that I lived in, my mother listened to, you know, Latin music because she's Cuban, and my father listened to doo-wop and stuff like that. You know, I guess they would be called doo-wop groups and stuff like the Beach Boys and stuff like that. My mother also listened to classic rock music and stuff like that, and my brothers and sisters, they were into oldies and funk and whatnot. And myself, I got into metal, but I listened to everything, and I think that stuff carried over when it came time for us to do music, because all of us have a similar musical background and tastes and stuff like that. So I think, being that we were all influenced by all these different sorts of styles of music, It came off in our music, in the imagery, in the attitude, and in the sound.
Now, if I've correctly understood the messages in your lyrics, You guys like getting high.
Yeah.
Right? Our neighboring state of New Jersey just legalized medicinal marijuana.
Yes.
Do you think that all states should legalize medicinal marijuana, or should it everything be legalized, period?
Well, first, it should be, you know, I think the medical marijuana law should be put in place first for those people who need it medically first. Then you come with the decriminalization so that if you're getting if you get caught possessing a little bit of weed or whatever, you're not going to go do no jail time. You're not going to get a criminal record for some petty shit like that. After they have that in place, then legalize it all across the board. Got my foot on the floor, I'm hitting switches and my frame is heavy. You want to look inside and see who's crossing the ride. Curiosity is killing you and stinging your pride.
The ban was on The Simpsons about, 10, 15 years ago, and in the show, you were accused of getting high and ordering the London Symphony Orchestra.
Right.
Would you ever actually play a live show with an orchestra?
Yeah.
And on the flip side, what's the strangest thing you've ever ordered or done while high?
Yeah, we would play with the orchestra because there are a few songs that we have that could play to that. You know, like Rock Superstar is one of the songs that we have that could probably play to have an orchestra there. And as far as the craziest shit we've ever ordered, I don't know. What, like instrument or just anything?
Anything. Craziest food you've ever ordered? Mm. Have you had the new KFC Double Down yet?
No, I have not had that.
That looks like real stoner food.
It was crocodile. We ate crocodile in Brazil.
How was it?
Fucking great. Get high, but we're flipping the set. Never flipping the script, but all you haters couldn't hold my dick. Don't need a clip, but my nine is straight. You should leave it alone and check your tone, cause my nine will spit. You did a remix of Paradise City with Slash and Fergie.
Right.
How did that come around?
It was cool. You know, Slash is a good friend of ours. We've been collaborating with him on various things throughout the years, and one of the things that you know, he had in mind was Paradise City because we had performed it with him at, you know, a bunch of different shows with this band called Camp Freddy. It's an all-star band. Dave Navarro, Slash himself, Billy McDuffie, I think that's his name.
Duff McKagan.
Corey Taylor likes to get in that.
And Billy something used to be with the Cult or something like that. I mean, so many fucking guys. You also have Matt Sorum on the drums, or sometimes they'll use Steve Perkins and stuff like that. So it's an all-star band, you know. They'll bring on Stevie Vai every now and then. Tom Morello has played with them. I mean, it's incredible. So they always ask Sendog and myself to come play, and one of the songs they always ask us to play is Paradise City. And the first time they asked us to play it, I was like, what? How the fuck are we going to do that? We can't sing. And somehow we figured out how to do it to make it interesting, and he liked it, so we wanted to record it, and this just so happened to be the time that, you know, we're like, all right, we'll do anything for Slash. You know, he's a good friend and a legend and somebody we respect, so when he asked us, we were all about it. We didn't know Fergie was going to be on it. We thought Alicia Keys was going to be on it. But it was cool because Fergie's a really good friend of ours. I've known her for many years before she was with Peas and everything. So it was cool to actually be on a collaboration with her.
Were you a Guns N' Roses fan before
this?
Oh,
yeah, for sure.
Have you heard the new album, Chinese Democracy?
No, I mean, look, I liked Guns N' Roses in the old form. Right now they're just guns. Or actually, they're just roses. There's no guns. You know what I mean? Till he puts the rest of the guys back there, that shit is not Guns N' Roses. Just because he owns the name means nothing.
So you're a GNR purist.
I'm GNR purist, just like Van Halen. Van Hagar, eat me.